हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज श्वेता रॉय। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास 8 चैप्टर 3 पार्ट 1 हिस्ट्री एग्रेरियन स्ट्रक्चर अंडर द ब्रिटिश। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स एंड सेटलमेंट्स implemented or introduced by the British. British came to India as traders. Their main purpose was trade and commerce. But the political unrest of our country in 18th century aroused the ambitions of the British, and they moved forward to political establishment. Now, they fought several wars against provincial governments to expand their empire. Also, to control the newly acquired territories, they developed a good system of administration. Also, they raised a strong army. Now we will discuss about the revenue system. As we discussed, to control the newly acquired territories, the British developed administrative bodies and they raised strong armies. Now to maintain their expenses, there was a need of increase in their financial resources. Now, how they can increase the financial resources? So, some of the ideas which came in front of them was maximizing the trade. By maximizing the trade, by increasing the trade, the finance can be increased. Next was buying raw materials from India at cheaper price and selling the manufactured products of England at higher price. Like this, there can be increase in the finance. Collection of land revenue from the provincial governors. If they will collect the land revenue from the provincial governors, there would be income. Apart from this trade, the British now was focusing on different sources of revenue. How they can collect revenue at different levels and they can get the benefit or they can increase their financial condition. Now we will discuss about the company as Diwan. What was the profits which company got by getting the Diwanis of the states? So in 1765, Lord Clive was the governor that time, and the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II granted Diwani of Bengal, Bihar and Odisha to the East India Company. And this was after the Battle of Buxar. Now in return, the Mughal Emperor was getting the annual payment of rupees 26 lakhs. Now the company appointed two deputy Diwans, one for Bengal and other for Bihar. The Diwani rights gave the East India Company full authority over financial resources in the territories which was under control, under the control of British. Now, soon the ill effects came forward. The tax collectors was only interested in the collection of more and more revenue. They were only looking towards profit. And they were hardly paying attention to improve the quality of land. Now, the poor peasants were exploited, and the harshness of revenue collection forced them to run away to jungles or to become robbers. Now, in this situation, when the tax collectors were only paying attention towards revenue, they were not paying attention towards improvement of quality of land, peasants were exploited, they ran away to jungle and they became robbers. In this situation, the agricultural production declined. Also, in the same time, there was the trade and commerce was also suffering. Now, there was a setback in Bengal. Skills of workers ruined under oppression, as the company was buying the products from India in very cheaper price, but it was selling it to Europe in higher price, much higher price. So they were getting a good profit, but the workers, that means the weavers of silk or the artisans, they were compelled to work under very harsh conditions. They were not getting good pay also, good money also for their work. So in this situation, their skills were ruined. And also, this was highlighted in the famine of 1770, which took place in Bengal. And in that famine, 1/3 of the population of Bengal wiped out. That was died. So here we can see, the company got the Diwani and the full control over the finance. But it was only focusing on the profit. It did not pay attention towards the people or towards the land or towards the workers. And in this situation, slowly, the agricultural production declined. After that, the trade and commerce suffered. And at last, there was a famine. In that, 1/3 population wiped out, died. So we can see the result was very terrible after this. The next system was quinquennial settlement. Now, this was introduced by Warren Hastings, who was Governor General that time. And it was introduced in 1772. Now, this was a 5-year settlement of land revenue. In this, states were given to the highest bidder. Now, in bidding, no preferences were given to the jamindars. The Hastings set up 6 provincial councils, and they were set up to supervise the work of Indian Diwans in district. Now, the corrupt tax collectors were replaced by the Indian Diwans, and A committee of revenue was set up in Calcutta. Now, this system also was proved a failure because the bidding process was not transparent. The state demand of revenue was fixed much higher than the produce of land. The Diwans resorted to harshness in tax collection. Now, after this result, Hastings reverted to the older system of open auction to the highest bidder in 1776. So, Quinquennial settlement was introduced in 1772 and it ends in 1776. From 1776, the process again went to the older system. Now the next settlement was decennial settlement. Now this was introduced by Lord Cornwallis and it was introduced in 1790. As we know, quinquennial system was a 5-year settlement system, but decennial system was a 10-year settlement which was made with the Jamindars. Now in this system, the Jamindars were required to pay annual revenues to the states, and that annual revenue which they were paying to the state was 89% of the rental. So they were keeping only 11% of the collection as their own share. Rest 89% they were giving to the state. And Jamindars were recognized as the owners of the land. Now the old committee of revenue was renamed as Board of Revenue, and in 1793 the decennial settlement was declared permanent. It became permanent and it was known as Permanent Settlement of Bengal. Now, as we already discussed, the Jamindars were the owners of the land. They were recognized as the owners of the land and they need to pay 89% of the rental to the government, state, and 11% only they were keeping with them. Now, this 89% was a fixed amount. In future also, it was not going to increase. Whether production increase, but the revenue will be 89% only. Now, this settlement also had its own problems. It is said that in this system created feudalism at the top and serfdom at the bottom. In this system, what happened? It was actually a financial disaster for the company. Why? Because if there is increase in production, still there was no profit for the company. कंपनी विल ओनली गेट 89%. नाउ ऑन दिस फिक्स्ड अमाउंट when there was increase in the production, the jamindars were getting more of the profit and they were becoming richer. On the opposite hand, when there was condition of famines or failure of monsoons, the jamindars were failed to pay the revenue. In that condition, the state demand was very high and the company officials oppressed the jamindars. Now they were deprived of their lands, which were sold by auctions to other jamindars. That means if there is a condition of famine or failure of monsoons and the jamindars were not able to pay the revenue to the state, they were deprived of their land. Land was taken from them and that land was sold in auction to other jamindars. Now, in this situation, the peasants suffered the most. They were totally depend on the jamindars for their living, as they were working on their lands. Their property rights lied with the jamindars. If there is production or there is no production, they had to pay the rent or they were deprived of their land they had cultivated for generations. Now the permanent settlements were made in Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, some parts of UP and North Karnataka. Now, this was covering 19% of total covered area of British. Next is the Mahalwari settlement. Now, this was introduced in 1822 and it was introduced in Western Uttar Pradesh, the central provinces, some portion of Punjab, and this was the 30% of British India. Now, in this system, a village or a mahal, which was a village or a group of villages, was made the unit of revenue settlement. A British secretary, Holt Mackenzie, noticed the importance of villages in the northern India, and his opinion was that the village land actually belonged to the village community and community will be responsible for the payment of land revenue. So if you notice, in quinquennial settlement, the land revenue was framed for 1 year, for 5 years, and the states were framed out to the highest bidder. That means whoever is the highest bidder, that person will be responsible for the land revenue. In decennial settlement, the jamindars were recognized as the owners of the land and they were responsible for the land revenue, for the revenue settlement. But in Mahalwari settlement, a village community was responsible for the revenue settlement. this system, the village land was inspected and surveyed, and after that, a record of rights of land was prepared. Now, the revenue that could be obtained from a particular land was estimated. After that, the estimated revenue of each plot was added. Then, the village or mahal was required to pay the entire revenue. Now, this demand of revenue was to be revised periodically. Now, by a regulation in 1822, the state demand was fixed at 95% of rental. And this system was also a failure because of excessive state demand, as state was demanding 95% of rental. And because of excessive state demand, the system failed. Next is the Rayotwari settlement or the Munro system. Now, this was introduced by Thomas Munro in Madras Presidency. And it was further extended to the Bombay Presidency and Assam. And it was covering 51% of British India. Now, before Munro, captor Alexander Reed tried this system on small scale, the area which was annexed by Tipu Sultan. Now, in South India, there were no jamindars and the land belonged to cultivators who were Rayots. And it was coming from generation to generation. Now, because of this, the land settlement was directly made with the Rayots. And thus, this system was known as Rayotwari. Now, in this, the fields of the Rayots were independently examined and surveyed before making the final assessment. The revenue to be paid by the cultivators depend upon the quality of land and crops produced. Now, the land revenue was fixed 50% of the rental and it was for maximum period of 30 years. The Rayot was to be the owner of the land as long as he can pay the revenue. This system too failed. And this failed in protecting the farmers from the clutches of distress and poverty. Now, the state demand was still high and independent of produce. Also, the cultivators were in the clutch of moneylenders. And in result, in many villages, the Rayots fled away, leaving their homes. And like this, the system failed. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.